Okay, so now moving to the next level. Before we get there, let's review quickly. To scale on one axis, or excuse me, two axes only, or eliminating one, kind of how you're looking at it, it goes like this. I want to scale only on the Z and only on the Y, right? So it's like saying you're scaling around the X. So it's basically like scale and then shift X, which more or less eliminates the X from the scaling, and it's only scaling on those two, right? So if you were scaling on the X, obviously you're going like that. So it's eliminating that from the equation. So it's scale shift X to scale that way, scale shift Z to scale only, excuse me, scale shift Z to scale only, let's clear that scale out there so it's more obvious. Scale shift Z, and we're only scaling there, right? And then scale shift Y to only scale like that. And that would be the same with move. Grab shift X, and I can only move it along this axis, right? No matter what I do, it'll always only move there. And scale shift Z, and I'm only, excuse me, grab shift Z, and I'm only moving it along this. I can't move it up or down, it's only side to side. So you get the idea, right? So that's how that works. That's to, it's very common to use it for modeling and also for animating. If you want to just animate something along a plane and never move it up and down, and you want to do it interactive like that, then that's one way to do it. Okay, so now it starts to get even more complex when you realize, oh, wait a minute, I only want to scale on two axes, but I want to do it in one of these transform modes. Then what? What would the shortcut be? Because up to now, well, if you've guessed it by now, you're right. It's actually exactly what you might have guessed. So if you have it rotated like this, we are in local, just for illustration purposes. Now, I want to scale it on everything but the x-axis, right? So before, if I wanted to scale it along the x in the local coordinates, it would be scale x two times, right? Okay, well, if you hadn't figured it out by now, here's what it is. Scale shift X X. And now I'm scaling it only on the X in this coordinates, right? And that works with all the other transform orientations that are set up here. I still have that random rotation from before. So let's take this guy and let's clear this out, excuse me. Clear out the rotation, and let's scale it along that random rotation that we have set up. So that would be scale XX, and so now, as you can see, it's scaling it on that random rotation that we had set up. It's hard to see it on the box like that, but that's what's happening. So now, you don't obviously need this on rotation because you've already got it, but it really works for, it would be more easier for to first illustrate for grab. So let's do grab shift X X, and now I'm only moving it along that plane. See how that works there? So it's a little bit more complex, but it's just simply adding more keyboard shortcuts, and when you're using these in production, it really does go real fast. So I think this one's going to be a little short because that pretty much covers all the keyboard shortcuts for manipulating something. But if we're going to review it, just don't forget that the transform orientations are here. You have these orientations here, local, view, global, and so on. All these play in a part in manipulating objects with the keyboard shortcuts. And I think that's fairly clear at this point, and we can move on to the next subject.